We talk a lot about cool gadgets and fun services on this channel, from smartphones to home automation to your favorite streaming options. While data usage has exploded over the last couple of years, our government's definition of broadband, it hasn't budged. Is it time for us to redefine broadband? No matter how fast your web connection is, you don't want to miss out on the work here on reviews.org. So I'm going to need you to do that thing you do with the subscribe buttons underneath this video. All right, let me take you back to the far-flung year of 2015. Maybe you were super jonesed about that new Avengers movie with the robots. Maybe you were cracking up about Left Shark. Maybe you were getting into heated arguments with your friends about what color that dress was, because it was obviously blue and black. Oh, 2015, it really wasn't that long ago, but it also feels like ages ago. But if you were into the geeky infrastructure scene, 2015 was the year we bumped up the definition of broadband internet for consumers. Before 2015, all you had to offer a consumer to qualify as broadband was a 4 megabit download and a 1 megabit upload. In 2015, the FCC under Tom Wheeler increased that definition to 25 meg downloads and 3 megabit uploads. Over the last year, especially with more work and school happening at home, I think a lot of us have found that our upstream connections are a little more important than we thought they were. I'm personally doing better than a 3 megabit upload, but not by much. And considering all the work I do in media and all the video calls I need to be on, poor upload speeds can pinch pretty bad. From 2015 to now, 25 down and 3 up is all a company needs to offer to legally call their service broadband. And in a lot of areas around the country, it can be tricky verifying that a consumer really is getting that service reliably. But this might change soon. A bipartisan group of senators are petitioning government agencies and regulators to bump up that definition. A letter from those senators is calling for a significant increase in upload and download speeds, and for those speeds to match 100 meg downloads and 100 meg uploads. This gets me all nerdy Twitter-pated. 4 times faster down, over 30 times faster up. And the first time broadband would be symmetrical since 1996, when high-speed internet was 200 kilobits per second up and down. Of course, this would just be the defined minimum speed for a service labeled broadband. And an ISP would still be able to offer faster and slower connections, but on the slower connections, they just can't advertise them as high-speed broadband. If this proposal moves forward and cable providers don't want to lose their broadband label, it might mean some more significant changes to services and support. Up to now, it's been exceedingly rare to find cable plans that offer more than a 50 meg upload. A lot of that infrastructure was built on the idea of consuming content more than supplying a service where people were more actively participating. There are a lot of moving parts to these conversations about broadband and closing the digital divide. Numerous debates are happening right now about infrastructure and how to invest in our economy. And at the same time, our regulators are having a difficult time verifying that companies are fulfilling their commitment to improving service when public funds are used to subsidize those businesses. The FCC recently just revamped their own speed test app, so you can check your own connection and send that data directly to the FCC. It's that kind of information which will confirm if our infrastructure spending is actually making an impact. If you're paying for high-speed broadband but not getting proper broadband speeds, it might be worth letting the FCC know. We're going to see a lot of debate about this topic and the larger conversation about getting people connected. So we want to hear from you. Is 6 years too long to keep the same definition of high-speed broadband? How often should we consider updating that definition? Drop us some comments down below. Let's have a chat. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos, and subscribing to the channel. For reviews.org, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell, and I'll catch you all on the next video.